Hey, what's up, guys? This is a quick video showing you how to make custom magnets with your 3D printer at home. I'll put this model on my printables profile, link in the description if you want to check it out. So for this project, we're going to be using Fusion 360 to create a model of a stop sign. So here we are in Fusion 360, although we're first going to start over here in this octagon calculator so we can get our dimensions. So I'm thinking I want this longest or this medium diagonal, they're calling it, to be 50 millimeters. So that's going to give me a side length A of 20.71 millimeters. So we'll take those dimensions back over here into our file. So to do this octagon, we're going to actually make a sketch. So click the sketch button and then click the plane that we want to work in. I'm going to build a series of rectangles. We'll start with these centered rectangles right on the origin. And then we're going to put in the values that we just calculated. So I want a 50 side and a 20.71 inch millimeter side. Okay, so that is the first rectangle we need to draw. You can see that we've got two of our sides now. So now we can draw another one that's also centered on the origin, but going in this direction. So we've got 20.71 and 50. And then we're going to need two more. This time we're going to do a slightly different rectangle. Instead of using the center rectangle here, we're going to use this 3-point to make sure we get exact connections to these corners. So we'll place our first corner, place our second corner to match, and then bring it out here to this corner. And now you'll see that one also matches as well. And then we'll do the same thing over here to get this last side drawn in. And we'll finish our sketch. And you can see we've got our octagon started. All right, the next step's gonna be to extrude this. So I'm gonna try to keep the model as thin as possible. So first we're gonna select it, click extrude, and we're actually gonna go up 3.4 millimeters. And now you can see it looks, perfect octagon, just like a stop sign. So next up, I want to cut the hole for the magnet. So let's go down to the bottom face. And the magnets I'm going to be using are 8 millimeters in diameter by 3 millimeters tall. So I'm going to create a hole, and I want to create it in this face, centered right there on the origin. So then I can come over to this menu, make sure it's a flat hole, and the height, as I said, is going to be 3 millimeters. And a width of 8 millimeters. Click OK, and as you can see, we've got our hole at the perfect depth. So now you can leave it like this, but what I like to do is actually make the magnet internal to the print. So to do that, I'm actually going to show this sketch again and hide the body. Go ahead and select this and extrude it some more. This time we want to make sure we're extruding downwards towards the bottom. So we can kind of drag this down. That went 1 millimeter. Like I said, I'm going to try to keep this really thin. So I'm going to go negative 0.4 millimeters. I usually use 0.2 millimeter steps. So that should give two layers of coverage over the magnet. The closer you can keep it to the wall, the stronger your magnet's going to be. So I'll hit OK. And then we will hide the sketch. Show the body now, and you can see the hole is still there in the middle, but now it's covered up by that 0.4 millimeters that we just put on. All right, the next step, we're going to just put a small border that's going to print in white around the red stop sign, like you'll see on a real stop sign. We are going to do that by building another octagon sketch on top of the first one. This time, it'll be slightly smaller though. We're going to go with a 19 by 46 millimeter rectangle. Make sure the first two are centered on the origin. The second two rectangles, again, we'll use the 3-point rectangle option to ensure the vertices all meet. When you have all four drawn, you can hit finish sketch. Now we have a smaller octagon sketch on the face of the larger one we drew earlier. So now we want to extrude the smaller octagon down into the first octagon. I'm going to start by hiding the bodies here and we want to select just this octagon sketch. So you can see there's kind of a faint blue outline there. Try not to get that in yours. So now that we've got that, I'm going to bring the body back. You can see there is this border here all the way around. So now we're going to extrude. Make sure we cut, and we want to go down 1 millimeter. When we press OK, you can see now we have this little dish, essentially, octagon with a dish in the middle, which is exactly what we want. All right, last step, we need to put our stop text on here. So to do this, we got to go back into sketch mode one more time. We're going to put it on this smaller octagon plane. You can go under Create here and put Text. So we want to make sure this is centered, so I'm going to drag it from this corner to this corner. Okay, and you see some sample text pop up. We obviously just want this to say stop. Let's go with the nice bold and make sure everything's center aligned. Probably go a little bit bigger here, maybe up to, that's too big, 12. Let's go 11. Now we can hit OK to first finish our sketch. We like to extrude these letters upward. So it's still got my text selected. I'm going to come up just 1 millimeter. That should put us flush with the border around it, which looks good. And then hit OK. And there we go. We've got our stop sign. And if you come to the bottom, you can see there's still the hole there hiding in the middle. And I'll show you how that works out on the printer. So now I need to export this file. File, export to an STL file. So click export. This will take a few minutes, and then we'll come back and check it out in Cura. So now we're over here in Cura. You can see it brought in our model here. So we've got our stop sign. We didn't change any dimensions or anything, so it's here in the center of the plate. We're going to start by slicing it, and then we're going to check out to make sure everything worked correctly through this preview function. So let's go down to layer 1. It's solid layer, layer 2 solid, and then like we said, layer 3, we wanted to start putting that hole for the magnet. So then we're going to print all these layers until finally it closes over the top right here. So layer 18. So right here at layer 17, we want it to print this layer and then pause so we can put our magnet right in that hole. And then continuing on, you can see our letters start popping up right here. So let's print layer 20, and then we're going to do our filament change. So we can do that by adding some post-processing steps under extensions. Modify the G-code. I'm going to pause at height. We're going to use layer numbers. So we put in the layer we want to print. So I believe that was 17 for the first one. We'll keep the motors engaged so nothing moves around. And then we'll park this out of the way, let's say at 50 and 50. We're not changing filaments. We're not going to do any retraction on this one. And why not just have a beep? Okay, so there's one, and then we're going to go ahead and create our other pause at height for our filament change. So that, I believe, was at layer 20. We'll keep the motors engaged. Also park it closer so we can reach it at 50-50. This time we do want to retract. I usually put in 25 here. Leave the standby temperature also at 200. Beep. Let's beep for 2 seconds this time. And that should be everything. Let's go ahead and correct this as well. Forgot to keep the standby temperature at whatever temperature you're planning on being at. All right, so now you can see we have two little extensions down here that are gonna occur. Now we can save this to the disk and get it over to our 3D printer. Here are a few shots of the finished model. The cool thing about this technique is that you can use it on all kinds of models you find online. With a couple of small modifications, you can turn it into a magnet for your fridge. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below and I'll get back with you as soon as I can. As I said, the model we created will be on my printables page, so you can look that up from the links in the description as well. I hope this video is helpful for you and you can use this to make your own custom magnets in the future.